and K291CN Kansas City. Gospel 1590, 106.1 FM.
It's 9 o'clock a.m. Welcome to the Morning Glory Show. Turn your volume up and let the word of God pierce your soul. 1590 a.m. on your radio dial and 106.1 on your FM, pal.
Thank you for tuning in to the Morning Glory radio broadcast with Drs. Adam and Adrian Blackstock of Glory Bible Fellowship International Church. Sit back and get ready to receive a word that will transform your life.
Good morning, radio family. It is great to be on the radio today. I haven't been on the radio in a long time, so it is awesome to be on the radio today. You are listening, of course, to the Morning Glory radio broadcast here locally at the Gospel 1590 KPRT and Gospel FM 106.1. You are also watching on Facebook at GBFIC's Glory Bible Fellowship's Facebook page and YouTube. And if you happen to be going by Facebook, you will also see it on my Facebook page as well. So let God do what he's going to do today. And there's a lot of things going on. Of course, today we do have church tonight. Church is at 7 o'clock. This is our Thanksgiving service. Every year, for as long as we've operated a church, we've moved our Thanksgiving service Tuesday of that week in order for people to enjoy their time with the family on Wednesday and Thursday and go shopping on Friday. So today is a Thanksgiving service and it will be a powerful time in the Lord. God will always fix everything that he's doing for you, and he will make things supernatural and breakthrough for you, and God will bless you. So again, this is you're listening to the Morning Glory radio broadcast found on 1590 KPRT and 106.1 FM locally here in Kansas City. But God is doing something now supernatural for you to be able to receive. Hopefully you're joining me on Facebook, you're joining me at the YouTube page, and you're joining me on the radio broadcast. You can find us everywhere and anywhere. Church tonight at 7, and then we will see you again on Sunday. I have a word for you today. Today's word is simply based on the month of 11, which is both the month of November, which is the month of shifting. And during this shift, it's normally a transition. Hopefully you guys can now hear and everything got going on. But this is a month of shifting. God has something for you. Go with me to the book of Matthew, chapter 4. We're going to read verses 1 through 11. Then was Jesus led up of the Spirit into the wilderness to be tempted of the devil. And when he had fasted 40 days and 40 nights, he was afterward hungered. And when the tempter came to him, he said, "If thou be the Son of God, command that these stones be made bread." But he answered and said, "It is written, man should not live by bread alone, but by every word that proceeded out of the mouth of God." Then the devil taketh him up into a holy city and set him on a pinnacle of the temple and said unto him, "If thou be the Son of Man, cast thyself down, for it is written, he shall give his angels charge concerning thee, and in their hands they shall bear thee up, lest at any time thou dash thy foot against a stone." Jesus said unto him, "It is written, thou shalt not tempt the Lord thy God." Again, the devil taketh him up into an exceeding high mountain and show him all the kingdom of the world. and the glory of them, and saith unto him, all these things which I will give thee, if thou wilt fall down and worship me. Then said Jesus unto him, get thee hence, Satan, for it is written, thou shalt worship the Lord thy God, and him only shalt thou serve. Then the devil leaveth him, and behold, angels come and ministered unto him. I see all those on Facebook. God bless y'all. Thank you for joining me. But let me give you this title and this message. In this month of shifting, in this month of transition, in this month of change, in this month of transformation, God is saying in this season, he's taking you from isolation to a point of revelation. I wish I had some help up in there. Somebody needs to say that they've been challenged, they've been isolated, they've been set aside. Just like Jesus, he was in a 40-day fast. He was in the wilderness all by him, all by his lonesome. But that time that you get by yourself, it takes you from a place of isolation to a place where God can bring revelation. I want y'all to help me today and get an understanding that revelation is coming on you and revelation is in you. Thank you for those that are listening to the radio in their cars. I don't want you to pull over, but I want you to tell yourself that you are being changed from a place of isolation to a place of revelation. Jesus was out there in the wilderness by himself. He was out there in a place where the enemy can attack him. But because he understood that being by himself didn't mean he was alone. Let me share that with you again. Sometimes we think that while we're in isolation, that means we're alone. No, that is a time where God can reveal to you some revelation and some information that you can only get while you are in isolation. Let me share this so you understand that God put himself alone so he can kill the devil that was trying to attack him and his people. I want you to understand in this season God is going to put you in a place of isolation, not be so that you can be alone, not so that you can't have somebody, not that you're not in relationship, not that you're needing this time. It's so that he'll put you in isolation so he can give you some revelation. I wish I had some help up in here. There is somebody that needs to understand in this season that you've been isolated, not because of who you are, but so that God can then minister to you an overflow of revelation. My Facebook family and those listening on the radio broadcast, I want you to just type in the chat or tell yourself you're in isolation so that you can get revelation. How many people know that even in a marriage relationship, you may be alone, you may be by yourself for a season? That is not so that you can be without your spouse or without somebody else. It's that time so that you can receive supernatural revelation. Even in your deepest, darkest moments, that's when God is going to reveal to you the supernatural things of him. You got to understand that if you've been in isolation as long as some people have, Jesus, many times he'd been isolated. Paul, he's been isolated. There is a time and a season where you can be in isolation just so you can receive a revelation. God will shift you from being alone to being with everybody. What am I saying? He's saying that he'll download so much word to you that you'll feel like you've been ministered to for years and you've got so much company in your life that the angels that is camped around you will take you into a new dimension in him, a new level in him. Some of us, yes, Sister Thomasina, yes, Brother Dale, Haquam, and others that are watching on Facebook, I want you to understand that God will take you from isolation, a place of being in your silo, to a place of revelation where he can download. Let me share this with you. I know I got this from Matthew, but you know that God gave the devil word, because the devil knows the word, but he doesn't have the rhema of it. He didn't have the revelation of it. God will give you a word that will seem ordinary to everybody else, but to you, it's a revelation. Now, y'all going to help me. Let's do this. Let's Acts chapter 16. Just go there. This is something that God is doing for you. He's taking you from a point of isolation to a point of revelation. If you don't get anything today, God said, don't be afraid of being by yourself. Because when you're by yourself, God can then download a revelation in this season. He's always shifting his people. He's shifting us from isolation to a place of revelation. Go ahead and just thank you, Elder Brenda. Acts 16:23, listen. And when they laid many stripes on them, they cast them into prison, charging the jailer to keep them safely. Who has received such a charge, thrust them into the inner prison. How many people know that sometimes you've been in an inner prison? Y'all not gonna talk to me. An inner prison, Sister Miles, is a place where God locks you up. It's not the holies of holies, because you've been surrounded by the enemy. Y'all know what I'm talking about. It's a place where you're not meant to get out, but you can only stay in. But what God is saying in this season, he puts you in a place of isolation, in the inner prison, in the inner struggle, in the inner financial struggle, in the inner physical struggle, in the inner struggle of your mind, in the inner struggle of your body, in the inner struggle of your salvation, in the inner struggle of your challenges, in the inner struggle of your family, in the inner struggle. I wish I had some help up here. Some of y'all have been in an inner struggle. There's a struggle in our minds of what, why did this happen to me? Why did this happen to my family member? Why did this happen to my child? Why did this happen to something going on? But God said, if I get you in a place of inner struggle, I could take you in a place of revelation. I could put you in a place of breakthrough. I could put you in a place of healing. I could put you in a place of deliverance. Let's look at this text right here. Acts chapter 16. And that midnight, Paul and Silas prayed. I believe when you pray, you'll get some revelation. I believe when you pray, you'll get some miracle signs and wonders. Some of us ain't praying enough when we get isolated by ourselves. When we get one-on-one with God, that's not a time for us to turn on the TV. That's not a time for us to play video games. That's a time for us to get a download from heaven. Sometimes you need to pray and just talk to God. God, why am I going through what I'm going through? Why am I challenged what I'm challenged? Why am I sitting here without any help? Why did I have to go through this and not the next man? Why? Paul went through all those machinations in his mind. Paul went through all those challenges in his mind. But what he found out is your situation shifts from isolation to revelation. Y'all got this on the radio. I believe y'all got this on the radio. Just come on, just smack somebody and tell them you've been moved from by yourself to the place of revelation. Just smack somebody and tell them that. Go ahead and do it. I feel like preaching today. I haven't done a radio broadcast in a while, so I feel it coming in. He said, and suddenly there was a great earthquake, so that the foundations of the prison were shaken. And immediately all the doors were open and everyone's band were loose. And the keeper of the prisoner, awakening out of his sleep, seeing the prison doors open, he drew out his sword and would kill himself, supposing that the prisoners had been fled. The prisoners that were Paul and Silas, who were isolated not just in jail, but the inner jail, they all of a sudden were the earthquake moved and the shackles taken off. When you get from a place of isolation to a place of revelation, That's when the shackles come. Y'all not gonna talk to me. That's where the shackles come off. That's where the challenges go away. That's where the revelation meets the road and a miracle happens. That's where your healing happens. That's where your deliverance happens. That's where your transformation happens. That's where your moving orders happen. That's where God tells you what to do next. Some of us have gotten free, but then wait for the instructions. Y'all not going to talk to me. I feel like talking to you. God did not make you free without any revelation. Come on now. There's somebody that needs to hear that. God did not make you free so not to give you a place of revelation. Just type in the chat if you're listening that God did not make you free without any instruction. Y'all not gonna talk to me. If you're listening on the radio and you're in your car, God is saying he didn't give you a new car to not give you the instruction book of how to run it. Y'all not gonna talk to me. When you get a driver's license, that's your license because you understand how to drive. God is saying you were by yourself when you learned that book, but now you're in a place where you can drive the bus. You're in a place where you can drive your car. Why? Because you've read the manual. Some of us get a car and never read the manual and wonder when things don't work right, what to do next. God is saying, if you just be isolated for a moment and you hear from heaven, God will give you the instructions that you need to drive yourself. God did not make you free without giving you instructions. He didn't take you from isolation to revelation without giving you instructions. Let's look what the Bible says. Let's look what the Bible says. The prisoner, the keeper, the jailer was getting ready to kill himself because he failed at his duty. Ooh, I've got a revelation right there. Don't you know that when you get revelation, that meant the enemy failed at his duty to destroy you. The enemy failed at his duty to destroy you. I want you to receive this, my radio family, my Facebook family. I want you to receive this. God is saying in this season, he did not free you to kill you. He freed you to give you a revelation like never before. Look what happened. Look what happened. God gave Paul some instructions. Let's see what he said. But Paul cried with a loud voice, saying, "Do thyself no harm, for we are all here." Everybody God freed was still in that place. Even though they were isolated in jail, even though they were struggling to wonder why they were imprisoned, God freed them, but he freed them with some instructions. He gave them a revelation with some instructions. Let's see what the revelation says. He said, "Then he called for a light, and he sprang in and came trembling and fell down before Paul and Silas and brought them out and said, 'Sirs, what must I do to be saved?'" There it is. God did not free you so that you could be by yourself. God did not take you from isolation to revelation so that you could miss the meaning of his freedom. God wants you to save your neighbor. God wants you to save your jailer. God wants me to save your enemy. Y'all not gonna talk to me. I know it don't feel good when you got to go and minister to your enemy and give them this same word that God freed me so that I could free you. God freed me from sickness and disease so that you can be free. God freed me from my selfish self. God freed me from my prideful self. God freed me from my drug dealing, my drug taking, my alcohol drinking, my fornicating self in order for you to be free. I'm not talking about nobody that don't know what I'm talking about. God is saying something right now, that you've been freed from all your sin in order for you to go free somebody else. God did not give you a spirit of revelation to stay by yourself. He put you up by yourself to give you a revelation to tell you how many angels he's got with you, how many angels he's got on your side, how many angels he's got working on your behalf, how many angels he's got employed on your behalf, how many angels he's got there for you. He's got many, many angels that are working on your behalf, not only to free you, but he's got those angels to destroy the enemy. Woo, I feel like I done preached 8 messages. But somebody need to catch the revelation. You've been isolated. Even when challenges come out, you've been isolated. even when your mind feels like you're by yourself, you've been isolated. Even though you've been shackled up, you've been tied up, you've been hurt, you've been beaten up. But God said in this season, he freed you so that this revelation would get out. And you could free somebody else. Some of y'all wondering why you went through what you went through. Why your marriage collapsed. Why your body is going down. God said, in this season, what you're going through is to get not only you free, but generations behind you free. Y'all not going to talk to me. Let me just say that again so that I can hear it. It didn't get just me free. It got my children and my children's children and my children's children and my children's 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 children all free. Generations behind me will know anything but prophetess and bishop are preachers, and they better live right and do right so that God can save them. Come on, this is a season where you move from isolation by yourself, doing your own thing, to freedom, where you can not only free you, but you'll free the many generations behind you. Whew, I feel like it. I feel like it. And we know that Paul saved the jailer. But let's move on to my last scripture and we're going to close. Revelation chapter 1. When you got it, say amen. I know you can't say it to me, but just I feel your amens right there. It's the last book of the Bible, Revelation chapter 1. And we got about 5 minutes left, 5.5 minutes. So God is going to move in this. He said, the revelation of Jesus, which God gave unto him to show unto his servants things which must shortly come to pass. And he sent and signified it by his angel unto the servant John, who bear record of this word and the testimony of Jesus Christ and all the things that he saw. I want to stay right here for a second. Blessed is he that readeth and they that hear the word of this prophecy, one prophecy, and keep those things which are written therein, for the time is at hand. God is sending this revelation, this one revelation, today's word. Y'all gonna talk to me today. And for that prophecy and this revelation, so that you could get free for multiple generations behind you. The John the Revelator in the book of Revelation was himself in isolation, in captivity in the Isle of Patmos. Some of y'all need to understand that you at your direst moment, you at your lowest season can get the greatest revelation. Y'all don't go talk to me. I want you to understand that you're going from isolation to revelation. There's a shifting going on in the body of Christ. I got about 4 minutes and I got to break this down. Some of you have just got the revelation that the reason why you're going through what you're going through is so that you could come up a level. Your faith goes up. Your healing goes up. Your miracle goes up. I see you, Dr. Ford. Everything that you're going on goes up a level because your isolation turned into revelation. Some of y'all writing books right now. Some of y'all are getting free right now. Some of y'all are getting delivered right now. When I lived in New York, I could walk by myself and do what I needed to do by myself. It wasn't like I was alone. I was just by myself, and I would walk and get to my destination with authority. But when I got there, I would always get a revelation of what I went through to get there. Y'all not going to talk to me. I would walk everywhere. I would drive everywhere. I would fly everywhere. I would do my thing. Most of the time I did by myself. When I worked at Norwegian Cruise Line and Disney, I was 60 to 70% travel. So when came January through March, I was barely home. But when I got to my destination, I see you, KPRT. When I got to my destination, there is something about getting a revelation about the journey. Some of y'all, Sister Chapman, have been fighting by yourself, it felt like. But God just wanted you to get you to your journey. Y'all, the radio land can hear me. Some of y'all need to understand that God is putting out miracle working power on your behalf. God is healing you. He's delivering you. He's transforming you. He's giving you a revelation like never before. This revelation, which is the greatest revelation in history, came in the darkest moment of John's life. In this last minute, I want you to consider this time and season as God shifts you from your darkest moment in your life to your greatest point of revelation. God is doing it. God is doing it. God is doing it. God is doing it. I want to tell you that in this season, just like in the book of Revelation, God is going to show you angels. He's going to show you healing. He's going to show you deliverance. He's going to show you transformation, just like he showed John the Revelator. I love you. God bless you. And I want you to know that in this season, God is shifting you from isolation to revelation, because in your life, Jesus is Lord.
If this broadcast has been a blessing to you, feel free to partner with us by sowing a seed at gbfic.org or mailing a check to Morning Glory at 1126 Northeast Delta School Road in Lee Summit, Missouri, 64064. If you need special prayer of any kind, please feel free to call us at 816-795-1900.